First Christian Church of Pittsburg. It's so good to be with you all here on this marvelous Lord's Day. Yes, and I have announcements next Sunday, January 29th. We will have one service at 8:30, followed by Sunday school, and that's it. I mean, if you all want to do something else besides that, you can. But that's what's planned. So, and during that service, we will have a congregational meeting to, we need to vote on a few officers that were at all the rest. And then we're going to vote to hopefully approve the 2023 budget, church budget. And then we will install all our officers. So that's happening during the service next Sunday. And then this Wednesday night at 6 p.m., January 25th, we'll celebrate Chinese New Year. Lily is going to make a whole bunch of dumplings and some other things. Yeah, a bunch of great stuff. So let me know if you plan to attend so she knows how much food to make. Any other announcements? Yes.
The VBS meeting is at 5 before that, if you would like to attend.
Yes, VBS meeting at 5 before Chinese New Year at 6. So you can make it an extra special night. Go to both events. Any other announcements?
Well, the service next Sunday be in here or in the sanctuary?
It will be in here, yeah. It'll be just like most other Sundays. So hopefully with more people. And oh yeah, also there is a white Honda just about as close to the front door as you can get, with a very, not completely flat, but pretty flat tire. I think it's on the passenger side and the rear. So if you have a white Honda right out from the door, then you can get some air in that tire. Or, if you need to...
It's me.
Did you? Oh, okay.
I didn't notice.
Oh, no.
It's okay.
Do you want me? I can, if it looks too low, I can change it out for you when we get done.
Well, it's a problem, a continuing problem with that tire. It has a slow leak, and I haven't ridden it for quite a while, so.
Oh yeah.
In fact, this is her first day driving.
First day driving, yeah.
Either be in recovery or home now. And then also prayers for my
name?
Her, okay, it's her father that had the surgery. Her friend, her name is Charlene.
Charlene?
Charlene.
Charlene. Okay. Okay. Pray for them. Anyone else? Joy?
I'm in the program at King Medical Center. I'm going back again Friday. I don't really know anything, but I feel like that this is the place where I need to be.
That my sister made it through. One of my younger sisters had a stent, which was this long and almost an inch wide, put into her, up by her iliac vein, which is below her belly button. It went through her leg and all the way up there to correct a thing, and she's doing really well with it. So.
All right. Okay. Any other joys or concerns? All right, well, let's worship Almighty God, the Father, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Please join me now in our affirmation of faith.
I believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, and I confess him as Lord and Savior.
Thank you.
doctor. All right, okay. I think we're good.
Cool.
All right. Let us pray. Holy, gracious, and loving Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for this day and this time to kneel before you in your presence, and we humbly ask for your Holy Spirit to be with each of us. Fill each of us. Let your presence be known here today among us, Lord. For we need you. We need you in our lives. We need you in every aspect of our lives. We need your help. We need your strength. We need your patience, your love. We need courage. We need comfort. We need a lot. We really do. We really do. And we're so blessed that you meet our needs, Lord. That you are always here for us. All the time. We can always turn to you. That your door is always open to us. You are always available. Thanks for this. We give you thanks for the work you do within us. We give you thanks that you help us to grow and to shine the light of your glory through acts of love and kindness in this world. We give you thanks for every opportunity that you give us to shine our light. Pray that you would make our light bright and keep us fully charged, very, very bright. Lord, today we also ask for healing for Frank and your blessing on him and Claudette. We pray that he gets to come home soon. We also pray for Charlene's dad, for his full recovery and for his family. Blessing on them, healing and comfort. We also ask for healing for Mindy and comfort and peace for her family. And continue to ask for healing for Julie and to give her a sense of your presence and your peace and bless her and her family. And we give you thanks today that Elaine's sister's procedure was successful. Pray your blessing on her and her family. We give you thanks that Elaine is able to drive again. That is such a blessing. And we pray all this in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Spoke with them. Afterward, all the Israelites came near, and he gave them in commandment all that the Lord had spoken with him on Mount Sinai. When Moses had finished speaking with them, he put a veil over his face. But whenever Moses went in before the Lord to speak with him, he would take the veil off until he came out. And when he came out and told the Israelites what he had been commanded, the Israelites would see the face of Moses, that the skin of his face was shining, and Moses would put the veil on his face again until he went in to speak with him. The word of the Lord. Time consciously spent with God, or prayer, brightens our light. Now, I'm not saying we will shine like Moses did, unless that there's a divine purpose for it, and which I can't think of one right now, but that doesn't mean that God can't or won't if he wants to make it happen. And as a, you know, imagine most of you or all of you know, God is full of surprises. And the shine coming off of Moses surprised and frightened his fellow Israelites. But it was actually a sign of comfort that God was still with them. See, our scripture reading takes place not long after the unfortunate golden calf event. When the Israelites had given up on Moses, he had spent a long time up on the mountain, supposedly with God, and they, well, thought he wasn't ever coming back. So they went ahead and they made their own God. And when Moses and God found out, they were ticked. However, when Moses came down the mountain this time, shining with the glory of the Lord, it showed the people that the one true God, the God of their ancestors, the God who had taken them out of slavery in Egypt, was still with them. And when we shine, in the figurative sense, we show people God is still with us, with everyone. It's like when Jesus said, "You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hidden. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a bushel basket, but on a lampstand. And it gives light to all the house. And in the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven." Yeah. And if we want to shine our absolute brightest, we've got to spend time with God in prayer. Like Moses. And Jesus too. Yes. You've probably heard the story about how Jesus took three of his disciples up onto a mountain to pray. And while he was praying, his appearance changed, his face changed, and his clothes dazzled, or became dazzling white. And suddenly, the disciples saw Moses and Elijah speaking with Jesus. I always wondered how they knew that was Moses and Elijah. No, I don't think they had name tags. Imagine he was discussing with Jesus. So maybe Jesus said, "Hey, what up, Moses and Elijah?" So that's who those guys are. And they were shining like Jesus too. And they talked about his departure, which was about to happen in Jerusalem. And the scene ends with God the Father telling Jesus' disciples, "This is my Son, my chosen. Listen to him." Yeah, those three disciples got even more reassurance of God's presence than the Israelites did from Moses, because not only did they get the shining Jesus, the Son, but also the words, the voice of God the Father. And this all started because Jesus was praying with his disciples. So if we want to really shine, we've got to pray. Yeah, our lights need recharging. And this is the one area in life where it's okay to be greedy. To say, "Lord, give me all you got. And keep it coming, because I want to shine my light for your glory." Yeah, that's perfectly fine. Take all you can get and don't worry about it. You can't exhaust God, believe me, I've tried. Even after all the whining I did to him my first year of seminary, he is still going strong. He is. Amen. So go for it. Get supercharged. Shine, shine, shine. And I had a shining mountaintop experience once on a mountain. And at least if it popped up in Kansas, we would call it a mountain. In Colorado, where it is, they call it a foothill. But I'm going to call it a mountain. That's easier. And I was out there in Estes Park, Colorado for a youth conference. And it was the final day of that conference, and most likely my last conference out there, because in just a few days, I would no longer be the student minister, aka youth pastor of the First Christian Church of Independence, Missouri. And I'd been to that mountaintop several times over the course of three conferences out there. I'd get up early in the morning before the kids, which was very easy to do, and I would go up there by myself and pray. And every time I went up there, I felt like I had to soak in as much of this amazing view as I could. I just sit there and take it in, because, you know, we don't have a lot of that here. It's very, very unusual what I was seeing up there. So amazing. And it was like that glorious vision of it was giving me something. It was filling some well deep inside of me. And I especially felt this the last time, because I was pretty sure it was the last time. So I could, get all I could. So as I'm doing that, I'm expecting like at some point when I'm full, something will ding inside my head to let me know, like, okay, that is enough. You've gotten enough. And it's not just the view, but that feeling of awe and wonder that comes from seeing something like that live and in person, and knowing that it was shaped by the hand of God and thus reveals the glory of God. So my soul is saying, give me, give me, give me. I was like Peter up on the mountain there. He was one of the disciples, one of the three up there on the mountain. And he wanted to build little shelters for Jesus and Moses and Elijah so they could hang out there for a while. But that wasn't the plan, to stay there. There was work to be done down the mountain. And how? Because something did finally ding in my head. I remembered that I had volunteered to set up chairs in our meeting hall in just a few minutes. And if I took the trail back down, it would take me at least 15. So I thought, I'm going to have to go, as the crow flies, I'm going to have to go straight there, straight down the mountain, which, is actually a foothill, which is just a big hill. But I want to let you know, if your joints are still fairly sturdy, bounding down a foothill is one of the most exhilarating things there is. I tell you, it's like flying, like I said in Toy Story, falling with style. It's amazing. And I was already full of the Lord anyway. I was already kind of floating as it was. So I go soaring down this hill, and as I go, I realize, oh my gosh, I'm in somebody's backyard. What in the world? How did these houses get up here? This is so strange. And this happened several times. Fortunately, none of them had fences nor giant dogs. So that worked out really well. And I got to the bottom of the hill. I got down to the meeting house nearly on time, so close. But I tell you, I had to be the most enthusiastic chair setter up of all time in that meeting house. It never happened like that for anyone before. I was on fire. Yes. Yes. But as we all know, fires fade over time. Sometimes it doesn't take very long at all. But they can be rekindled. They surely can. And we don't have to depend on awe-inspiring views to do that for us. I mean, I'm not dissuading you from doing that. We ought to, you know, take in as much of God's wondrous creation as we can. What I'm saying is that there's a more immediate and ever-present source of power for our light. And the Apostle Paul explains this in his conclusion, in the conclusion of his commentary on today's scripture reading. It's in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, 17, 18. He wrote, "Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is freedom. And all of us, with unveiled faces, seeing the glory of the Lord as though reflected in a mirror, are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord, the Spirit." Amen. "And the Spirit of the Lord is within each of us, so that we may be transformed and shine with the glory of the Lord for the glory of the Lord." And it helps if we're actively involved in this process. And we do this through prayer. So if you want your light to be brighter than ever before, pray, pray, and pray some more. I did not intend for that to rhyme. But it just happened. That's not even how I wrote it. But anyway, take all you can get. It's okay to be greedy. You cannot exhaust God. Just keep on soaking up all he has to give. And don't worry, he'll tell you when it's time to stop and get to work, to get to shine. Amen.
Amen.
And if you would like to shine as a member of this congregation, we ask that you come forward after our communion.
Thank you.
and we are all welcome, everyone is welcome, all people are welcome to come up here and dine with him, to celebrate what he has done for us and the life we have in his holy name. For it was on the night when our Lord was betrayed that he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it. He said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way, after supper, he took the cup. He said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Please pray with me. Holy and loving God, we give you thanks for this mountaintop experience. We give you thanks for Holy Communion. We give you thanks for the table of your Son, Jesus Christ, and for all that we have to remember and celebrate here. We ask your blessing upon the bread and the cup. We ask that this be truly be a time of Holy Communion, encounter your divine presence. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Come to the table. God, blessed be your children, blessed be bearers of your light, blessed that your Holy Spirit dwells within us, and we ask that through your Spirit you would guide us, give us the power to shine and show us where to shine, and we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.